While Utah is well known for its stark desert rock formations and scenery, the state also contains something else that few people ever think of, volcanoes. And two of these volcanoes are in fact active, with, for example, this background footage you are seeing not representing a burn scar, but instead showing a young lava flow west of the town of Fillmore. This lava flow, known as the Ice Springs lava flow, was in place 9,500 years ago during a volcanic eruption which covered 16.6 square miles in a fresh layer of lava. While yes, this was still a fairly long time ago, in 2018 and then again in 2019, we received a friendly reminder that this broad complex known as a Black Rock Desert volcanic field is still active. During that time span, two suspicious earthquake storms struck 19.5 miles to the southwest, which were not tectonic in origin or related to human activity. Instead, they were definitively volcanic earthquakes caused by small volume movements of either hydrothermal fluids or magma, marking what are known as hybrid earthquakes. However, don't let these volcanic earthquakes scare you, as they really aren't indicative of this complex erupting in the near future, as they merely represent background activity at many world volcanoes. Yet, because this overall volcanic field could one day erupt again, given the amount of nearby infrastructure and nature of its past eruptions, the U.S. Geological Survey designated the Black Rock Desert Complex as a moderate threat volcano. While eruptions of the Black Rock Desert volcanic field can be potentially destructive, they have also resulted in the formation of highly valuable gemstone deposits that have even produced a portion of one of the planet's most valuable gemstones. That gemstone is red beryl, which is worth between $10,000 and $50,000 a carat in top-quality gem-grade form. Those deposits are associated with the single oldest eruption this complex has produced, dating back 6.1 million years ago at Topaz Mountain. The Black Rock Desert volcanic field covers a vast area spanning slightly more than 2,000 square miles. While technically considered one large volcanic field, this vast area can be divided into five subfields which were each active at varying times, although today only the Ice Springs subfield is considered still active, meaning future eruptions are unlikely to occur elsewhere in the broader field during the next several thousand years. The Fumeral Butte subfield emplaced significant amounts of highly viscous rhyolite lava domes that created Topaz Mountain and its gem deposits 6.1 million years ago, the basaltic andesite shield volcano called Fumeral Butte 900,000 years ago, and a lesser volume of basalt eruptive centers, including a 1,500-foot-wide Mare explosion crater dated to 300,000 years ago. A rhyolite lava dome complex volcano was created in the Twin Peaks subfield, eventually leading to a powerful explosive eruption that formed a caldera and distributed a widespread ash layer, with all of this occurring between 2.7 and 2.1 million years ago. The Beaver Ridge subfield formed the namesake basaltic center cone of the overall volcanic complex known as the Black Rock Volcano 670,000 years ago. Between 1.5 and 0.4 million years ago, multiple additional basalt lava flows in andesite, dacite, and rhyolite lava domes were produced. The Cove Fort subfield was active between 1.3 million and 0.3 million years ago, producing a chain of rhyolite lava domes and some basaltic cinder cones. The recent center of eruptive activity, known as the Ice Springs subfield, has created all volcanic centers within during the last 100,000 years. Between 30,000 and 13,000 years ago, a massive lake known as Lake Bonneville spanned much of the state, meaning that any eruptions that occurred in this time span interacted with water in a highly explosive manner. As numerous explosions repeated throughout an eruption, ash largely fell close to the vent, forming what is known as a tuff cone. Pavant Butte formed in this manner 15,500 years ago, while the Tabernacle Hill tuff cone formed 14,000 years ago. However, the Tabernacle Hill eruption also emplaced a 7-square-mile lava flow. The most recent eruption that created the 16.6-square-mile Ice Springs lava flow occurred 9,500 years ago in a Strombolian eruption that created tall lava fountains and produced moderate ash emissions from a cluster of four cinder cones. The next future eruption from the overall Black Rock Desert volcanic field would most likely occur in the ice spring subfield and form a new cinder cone with an associated several square mile lava flow and a mildly explosive eruption that has a basalt to basaltic andesite composition. The chance of the next eruption being a highly explosive lava dome forming rhyolite eruption, while plausible, is far less likely. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Lisa, for supporting this channel.